welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. If you guys have a Mazda, okay, Mazda vehicle guys, and after you replace the crankshaft position sensor, the car does not start or does not run normal guys, stay with us and we're going to cover what needs to be done now guys. Most of you think that you just replace the sensor and you're ready to go. And that's how it is on most vehicles, but not all of them. And we'll guys demonstrate why this is different, what you need to use, how you need to fix that, and you can do it at home. Now, we'll guys have more than 200 videos on every vehicle we get at the shop because our mission guys is to save you as much money as we can. So please guys, subscribe to the channel, like the video, and drop a comment below. Let us know if the video was helpful. Now let me show you guys. We have that Mazda engine out of the car here. We have another one there as well. Okay, this is the whole engine assembly out of the vehicle. And we often guys in the past had problem by people complaining that they replaced the crankshaft position sensor and the vehicle doesn't start. Okay, let us explain you guys what is causing that now. So this is guys right here. Okay, you can see the crankshaft position sensor. Okay, right here next to the crankshaft pulley known as harmonic balancer pulley. Now, most people guys will just, okay, remove that thing and put it back on, right? Okay, you're going to remove two bolts and you're going to go ahead and remove the sensor. Okay, right? And just get the new one. Now, the problem with that thing is guys, okay, that sensor can move up and down. Okay, and if you install it in the wrong position, okay, what's going to happen? If you install it guys in the wrong position, as a result guys, okay, your car will not get the correct data and it will not throw the spark at the time that it's supposed to. So how you fix that? Okay, you don't have to remove the engine out of the car, but now we can show you guys a little bit better. Okay, so now right here on the back side of the block you have one bolt with a 10 millimeter usually socket. It could be different size for yours guys, it really depends. So I'm going to go ahead and remove that thing now. Okay, perfect. Now, you need to bring the engine, guys, okay, to top dead center, TDC point on cylinder number one. And you will, guys, need a special timing tool, okay, timing pack. All the tools and parts, guys, that we use will be listed in the description of the video below, guys, so please check it out. Now, this timing tool will go in the hole where we remove that 10 millimeter, okay, 10 millimeter bolt. You need to get it all the way tight. Okay, you don't need to use any big tools or anything like that, guys. Just you need to get it tight to where it stops turning, okay, with the tool. But be careful because those usually are made out of aluminum. Okay, perfect, like that, and you don't want to break them. Now, you're going to bring the engine, guys, to TDC point. Okay, we're going to turn the crankshaft, okay, until it stops turning. Okay, let me show you now quick here. And this one guys will be top dead center because the crankshaft will contact that okay, right there, that's it. You can see I can go back a little bit, but it stops there. This is top dead center. So with the tool being installed there, now some Mazdas may differ. This is on a CX-7. This engine is used on Mazda 3, Mazda 6, the 2.3 turbo engine, but it will work on many cars guys. What do we need to do now guys? First, you can see here on the sensor, okay, there is one line, okay, right here. Check this thing out, there is one line. So that line needs to be aligned with a 20th tooth, okay, tooth number 20. You can see here you have an empty space and then you start counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, 20 guys, tooth number 20. So I need to pick it up and align it with tooth number 20. Okay, it will be this one right there. And I need to guys, okay, get it tight at this position. So what we are going to do now, okay, let's just hold the camera like that here. I'm going to align it here, get the 8 millimeter. Okay, and get it tight. So you can see this is ready. Now, next step guys, okay, you will need to, okay, we'll need to get the tools again, okay. We need to get the 16 millimeter in our case, okay, for that bolt. We need to get that thing loose now. Okay, take it all the way off. Now I'm going to get the 10 millimeter that we removed earlier, this bolt here, and we're going to install it. And I'll just get it tight now. Don't forget to plug your wire in, okay? That will be your next step, guys. So just plug the wire in. And now, you can see, without that timing too, I can turn the engine more, okay? And it will be freely turning. It's very important not to forget to remove that timing too, because if you try to start the car, you can cause severe damage to your engine, guys. So, if your Mazda doesn't start, that could be the reason, guys. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Please hit that subscribe button for more videos. And see you guys next time.